This is CBS.
Hello, I'm George Sells.
And I'm Donna Britt. New figures out tonight on the victims of the tornadoes in southeast Louisiana. The number of homeless is over 650 people now.
The debris is out of the way. The sooner they can begin rebuilding. I'm Jerry Bro. That's the story today from Grove State.
Also tonight, questions why the Weather Bureau didn't give any warning about yesterday's storms.
And what do you think would be the most unhealthy occupation in all of China right now?
Newsline 9 is next on Louisiana's News Channel.
Thank you for watching WAFB Channel 9, Louisiana's News Channel. This is Newsline 9 at 10 with George Sells, Donna Britt, meteorologist Mike Graham, and sports with Andre Morrow.
I think Dad is going to rebuild.
Your father's going to stay here?
Yes, I think he's going to stay here.
Daddy is 75-year-old Lewis James. He's lived here nearly all his adult life. His son's working in Grove State tonight to get out what they can.
They've got to work under lights driven by generators. They may have to work all night because tomorrow morning, the bulldozers come to Daddy James's house to knock down what's left.
New figures out tonight show that 38 buildings have been destroyed or damaged in Little Grove State.
The town is still under a nighttime curfew, but during the day, it looks like a full-scale reconstruction project. Newsline's Jared Breaux reports.
The face of Grove State was being changed as rapidly today as it was defaced yesterday. Every ounce of effort was being channeled toward cleanup.
To speed up recovery efforts, everyone with a destroyed home in Grove State was asked to sign a release form this morning, clearing the way for the National Guard to come in and begin cleanup.
We're going to tell them y'all going to come back with a truck.
The National Guard roared in like a lion, helping residents save those last few items, then moving in with heavy equipment to remove the remaining debris. For many, the last reminder of their home is gone.
Well, now I start all over. That's it.
One reminder that will frighten many residents for some time to come are the many constant trains that pass through Grove State. For years, victims have said that tornadoes sound just like trains. Many thought the tornado that destroyed their home was simply just another train passing.
I listened, and I know it sounded like a train was coming. And I know when a train comes, that when they get to a certain point, they blow. They get so close and they blow because they have the railroad crossings there. And the horn never did blow.
What did blow was a wind so strong, nothing in its path is still standing. The next few days will bring more inspectors and insurance adjusters with hopes that construction on new homes can begin in the next few weeks. In Grove State, Jared Breaux, Newsline 9.
While in Grove State today, our Newsline crew went up for another aerial view of the area. We traced to the storm's path to its source. Take a look at this. The birthplace of the Grove State tornado is in an open soybean field. It was a narrow path more than 1 mile long before it slammed into Grove State. Driving eastbound on Interstate 10, you can see broken trees for several miles. That sort of indicates that the storm continued well past Grove State. Authorities report a peaceful night in the shambles of North Baton Rouge. Authorities have been heavily patrolling the areas stricken by tornadoes. The Louisiana National Guard has been in and out most of the day in the Southern Heights subdivision in the Banks area. The worry is looters, thieves stealing what little the tornado victims have left, but so far no reports of major theft. Cleanup crews have been busy trying to clear down trees and debris. Churches in the area have begun collecting clothes and supplies. More than 300 tornado victims from Southern Heights, Banks, and the Sharon Hills subdivision have been eating breakfast and lunch at a makeshift Red Cross cafeteria.
We have updated damage and injury figures tonight after a survey of the Metro Baton Rouge area by damage teams of the American Red Cross. Adding homes and department units together, there were 75 destroyed. Total destruction. Add another 142 homes or apartments with major damage, and you have 217 housing units that are uninhabitable. The Red Cross estimates more than 650 people are homeless in our area. As for people, two are dead. A bank clerk in Grove State and a 30-year-old man from Irwinville who was visiting in Grove State, as well as 49 people treated in hospitals. Of those 49, though, only six were considered to have injuries serious enough to keep them in hospitals. Meanwhile, many people are still asking, why was there not any warning from the National Weather Service? Less than an hour before the huge twister was crossing the Mississippi River here, the National Severe Storm Center in Kansas City had canceled all precautions about violent weather. The Weather Service here in Baton Rouge, which had the power to issue a local statement on violent weather, issued no such warning. This WAFB recording of weather radar in that critical hour when the twisters were developing backs up an explanation from the Weather Service. That explanation is the weather returns on the radar did not look that threatening. Look closely at the green blob immediately southwest of Baton Rouge. There are small specks of strong rain areas, but not especially intense.
That particular area, the one that produced these thunderstorms, had actually started diminishing in intensity. Mm-hmm. And the tornadoes that were produced from these thunderstorms were produced from fairly moderate thunderstorms.
In other states, there have been attempts to sue the National Weather Service for failure to give adequate warning about violent weather, but those legal actions have been totally unsuccessful.
He may be in critical condition, but authorities say a Baton Rouge man will face rape charges. Their story of catching him in the act, next on Newsline 9.
And you'll find volunteers where the going is roughest. We'll show you the heroes of tornado relief ahead on Louisiana's News Channel.
It's not often police catch a rapist in the act, but authorities say they have today. 24-year-old Michael Gordon of Baton Rouge is in critical condition at a local hospital tonight with a bullet wound to his abdomen. Police say the investigating officer had to kick in a locked door to stop Green from sexually assaulting a woman at Valley Park School in the College Drive area. Green allegedly lunged at the officer with a knife. That's when the shot was fired. The woman's hands were already bleeding from trying to fend off the sexual attack and the knife. Gordon is facing charges of aggravated rape and attempted first-degree murder. Officials say security is being tightened at Valley Park School.
Is China headed for a second cultural revolution? It became clear today that being a student in China very often marks you for arrest. In front of American cameras, Chinese troops were rounding up students for arrest. On Chinese television, these people being picked up were described as hooligans, enemies of the state. Now, if you look at the campus of Beijing University, the place looks almost deserted. A few Americans are left behind. And the Chinese?
Most of them have gone back home, back to their towns. They've just gotten on trains and gotten out of here. They're really scared. So, for good reason.
Most of the people think the army's going to come any minute, take students away, maybe the professors away, people that are involved in the protests.
Chinese troops presumably are using photographs taken during the demonstrations to identify people who led the democracy movement. What's to happen to those being arrested is not clear. But Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping, in his first public appearance in weeks, made clear today that their treatment will be harsh. The Soviets have a little trouble on their hands as well tonight. Soviet television people used to love to show pictures of America's race riots in the 1960s. Now the advent of Glasnost has brought rioting pictures on Soviet TV stations from their own country. This is Uzbekistan in West Central Asia. It started out as a battle between Muslim factions. Now their fury has been turned on Moscow. Thousands of Soviet paratroops are being flown in to put the trouble down.
Here at home, new evidence today of increasing inflation. A new economic report out of Washington shows an increase of 0.9% in May wholesale prices. That's twice the rate this time a year ago. If you take these figures and project them to an annual rate, wholesale inflation is running at 9.4%.
When meteorologist Mike Graham gets here, he's going to show you remnants of that weather system in the south that did so much damage here in Louisiana. Elements of the system have now been photographed in East Point, Florida. Look familiar? In this little fishing village, 19 homes have been destroyed and 3 people killed. They were all members of the same family.
They are deadly.
More photographs taken by home video cameras of that tornado in East Point, Florida.
And you're seeing more of those pictures now since so many people have home video cameras. It's amazing to me they have the wherewithal to stand there and look it in the eye.
I trust I'll never be in a position to take one of those pictures myself. Today was a calm day. Temperatures warm. Very close to seasonably normal. The weekend looks good for the most part. Maybe a shower or two Sunday. A little system moving in from the west. The clouds, I'll show you in just a moment. We'll look at the whole weekend straight ahead. Thank you. chance of rain inland tomorrow isn't very big. The chance of rain to our south pegged at about 20% near the coastal plain. It's certainly going to be a warm weekend. I think the afternoon high will be about 90. This is what you'll find as you wake up tomorrow morning. This frontal system will be across the northern part of the state, and there's not too much support here. The showers will be breaking out across the central plains. This is the map as it looks tonight. There are a lot of thunderstorms to go around out there. The upper level winds indicate a little...